Okay, so we have many students who were not able to do so, but no issues. We would be guiding them. We would be supporting all of you to get the access of those resources, and so that you can start working on the quiz and can ensure your certificate for the bootcamp. Okay, so now I will start with our today's part. Okay, so again, welcome to the CodeEver 2021 Mission AI Bootcamp number one. And today is the day three where we are going to learn about the object detection. But before that, let's see what do we have. So as you already know that CodeEver 2021 International, we have title sponsors as Motwani Jadeja Foundation. This competition is hosted by STEMpedia and ARTPARK, AI in Robotics Technology Park, which is an initiative of IISc Bangalore. Our competition is accredited by STEM.org. We have MySkill Schools and Valier FabTechs as an AI education partner. We have amazing prize sponsors, Hero Cycles, LilyGo, Sun Founder, and Zypher Toys. We have also good community partners who are spreading the words of artificial intelligence to the students around the world. We have Gurushala, Niti Aayog, Agastya Foundation, Jodo, Mission AI, and iStart Valley. Now, I hope you might have already downloaded the PictoBlocks and installed it in your favorite device. But again, if you have not downloaded the PictoBlocks, no need to worry. You can scan this QR code on your screen. Also, we are going to share you the links on the chat. From there, you can download the PictoBlocks in all your devices so that you can learn and make projects in your ease. So I would be helping you regarding the registrations in the PictoBlocks, like signing in into the PictoBlocks, but don't worry. Yeah, we would be sharing the attendance form. Don't worry, Vartika. But still, as I mentioned, the first thing is, like, if you have not downloaded the PictoBlocks, don't wait, okay? Please download the PictoBlocks, and the link is, so now you can see, we are going to share you the link to download the PictoBlocks. So students, if you want to download it in your laptop PC, here is the link. If you want to download it in your Android phone, this is the link which you can use, which I'm just now pasting on it. If you are using the iOS application, that is iPad or iPhones, so again, you can use the link mentioned on the chat to download the PictoBlocks. Now, a small recap that what we did last day. So if you are new, don't worry, the things we are starting. So we are going to give you a small recap. So we talked about, so the questions of the students, right? So we would be taking your query, students, towards the end of the session. Don't worry, I would be demonstrating you each and every part, each and every issue you are facing, okay? So now, a small recap. So last session, we saw the introduction to artificial intelligence, where we were able to see how, what exactly AI is, that to which machines we are calling, that these are enabled with artificial intelligence. Then we came up onto the applications of AI, that where exactly the AI is used, like we saw about expert system, gaming systems, and making recognitions, okay? Now, the next part was how the face detection works. So hope you remember that the face detection works with the, you can see the image as well, with the face landmarks. It is detected, it first detects the face landmarks, then it makes a pattern, and after that it compares it with the knowledge what computer have. Now, the next part was making a face expression detector activity. So I hope you all have already made this activity, okay? And if not, if you are finding a problem, don't worry. Don't worry about it. We would be sharing the replay video. That would definitely, we will be sharing you a replay video link that is going to definitely help you to revise the lesson. So as I mentioned, don't worry if you have not attended the last sessions. We have a replay videos for you. So let me just paste the playlist for all of you. So I'm just stopping the chat for as of now, so that you can all get the links with you. So this is the link for the replay. Okay, you might have also received this in your emails, and today after the session also you would be given the link in your emails. But still, if you want to have it, you can have it from here. Let me just change a little bit to this. So this is a playlist for the replay video. Okay, so I think now it's on your chat box. So if you have missed any of the sessions, no need to worry. You can revise, or you can just check out the videos onto the YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe the YouTube channel. Now coming to the next part, the object detection. So as you know, today we are going to learn about the object detection, that how exactly it works, what are its benefits, what are its different application, and how can we make an activity into the PictoBlocks. So are we all ready to learn the object detection? So can we have your response on the chat with object detection? That will make me understand that we are all excited to learn this topic. So you can just write OD, okay? You can just write OD, that means object detection, on the chat. That will give me an understanding that we all are excited to learn today's topic. Can I have your responses on the chat, students? I'm waiting for your responses of OD. That will give me an understanding that we are all ready to learn today's topic. So I'll just check with Nirav. Nirav, am I audible clearly?
You are audible.
Okay, that's great. Okay, so now I think, I'm sorry, I disabled the chat, okay, and I was waiting for your chats. So now, now let's move to, I can see now the OD on the chat. Okay, thanks, students. So now we'll move further with today's topic. Okay, so the first things come up, that what exactly the object detection is, okay, and where are the different fields we are locating it. Right, where are the different fields we are using it, I should say. So object recognition is a general term to describe a collection of related computer vision tasks, okay, that involves identifying the project in different photographs. So you might have been thinking what exactly this is written, and that how exactly I'm going to relate to it, okay. So you can see the image here, okay. You can see a video is running on just beside of it. What exactly this means is that object detection is a normal technique of a computer vision, okay, which is able to find and locate the different objects. Like you can see on the image, that the machine is able to detect the bus, the person, the people, I should say the car, the motor. So I hope I'm audible. I think there was some technical glitch. That's why I just came out of just went out of the room. Nirav, am I audible? Yeah.
You are audible.
Okay, that's great. So now I am available. I can see where he is, where the sir is. So I'm here now. Okay. Can you see me and hear me properly, students? Okay. Yes. Okay. Thanks, Zara, Rivend. Okay. Thanks for mentioning. Okay. Vikhyat, Odi, I got your message here. Okay. Devansh has mentioned audible. Your video and audio is clear, mentioned by Tanmay, Jeshri, and all the students. So thanks for responding on the chat and confirming it. So we were talking about the object detection, right? So as I mentioned, that object detection is basically, you can say it as like it is going to, it's a set of activities. It's not a complete one thing, but it's a set of activity where first it is analyzing the different images. Okay, after that, it is coming up with the detection of the objects. And the third part, you can say it is locating the different objects with the bounding box and coming up with a tag, right? So this complete thing's called as a object detection. So as on the slide also, it is mentioned that it locates the presence of object with a bounding box. So you can see it was in the image also. So it is able to detect the people, person, bus, car, everyone, and also coming up with a bounding box. So this is what we call as an object detection. Now the things come up that how exactly this object detection work. Yeah, Jayashree, I will take your question. So the things come up that how exactly this object detection work. So object detection works in the three steps, okay? This is very major three steps, although there are very small steps in between. But if I talk about a major three steps, so the first is it generates the small segments in the input. So you can see a picture of a person holding, I should say, a baseball bat. Of course, there is a ball, right? So now this is the first part. What happens in backend, or I should say in background, is it is able to, okay. So Mr. Nirav, I would kindly request you to paste the attendance form as well. Okay, I'll just paste this. Okay, so this is the attendance form, students. You can fill it later or you can fill it, but the first important thing is you should also be present at the session. Okay, so you can fill it later. You can keep the link with you. So now talking about that, how exactly this object detection is working. So as I mentioned, the first part is it is going to generate the small segments. So you can see the picture is now being divided into the segments. Okay, and after that, you can see the second points come up that there are features extracted from the segmented rectangular area to predict there is an object or not. So in the second picture, you can see there are very small rectangles, and now the new rectangles have came up. Okay, so they are trying to detect whether this is an object or not. Okay, so now you can see here, you can see there is a small box near to a ball. There is a box onto the bat. Okay. You can see there are two boxes on the person, right? So just in this way, there come some many boxes. So for just demonstration, we have showed you a small boxes, but what happens here is there are many big boxes coming up here. Okay. Which is going to basically, just give me a second. Which is going to come up and predict whether there is an object or not. Okay, once the objects are finalized, okay, The third steps comes up that the overlapping boxes. So you can see there are so many overlapping boxes, right? So if I talk about a one object that is a person, so you can see there are three different boxes, right? So what happens here is the final output is that it is able to detect the multiple objects after overlapping the small boxes. So now the machine told us, okay, after finalizing all the things, I found the three objects. One is a person, one is a bat, and one is a ball. So yeah, Abhiraj, you can ask your doubt. So I hope this part is very clear. I'll just give you a small recap on this. So the first part, what happens here is the image is first divided into small segments. Okay, so this input image has been divided into very small segments. After that, the features are extracted and a new rectangular box come up overlapping each other, where they are trying to detect or predict that there is an object. Once this is finalized, you get a final output that, yeah, confirm this is one object, this is one object as a bat, and this is one object as a ball. So I hope this part is pretty clear to all of you. Now moving to the next part is, of course, the thing which you always wait for, that is making an object detector. So I think we all are very much ready for this. Okay. So now I will just stop my share and we'll move to, we'll move to directly to the picto blocks. Okay, I hope my PictoBlocks screen is visible to everyone, right? So no worries if you have missed the attendance form for day one, no issues karne ka. Okay, there is no problem. How to get a new project? So I will tell you, you can get a new project by going to the file and clicking onto the new. In this way, you will be able to get a new project. Okay. I think Jayashree and some of the students were asking this question. So you can get a new project by clicking on the file and then clicking on the new button. Okay. So now coming to back to the point which we were discussing about the object detection. Okay. So now how we can make an object detector into our own PictoBlocks. So the first part, which is very, very important, is signing into PictoBlocks. So right now I'm signed in, so I'll sign out myself. Okay, and now I would be signing in back. I would be showing how you can sign in. So I would request all the students to see this very, very carefully, because this is a very major step for making this project. Okay, without signing in, you won't be able to use this extension. So make sure you sign into the PictoBlock. So as soon as you click on sign in, okay, if you are new user, you have to click on register. After that, you have to click on student. You have to mention about your age, and then you have to give your email ID. After this, you have to create your own username, create your own password, confirm that password, and click on create my account. This process is going to send you an email onto your email ID, which you have mentioned. And there you have to click on I agree to agree. You have to click on I agree, and that will verify you as that you are the owner of the email ID. Okay. And then you have to come back to this screen, just fill small information and you will be signed in. Okay. Also, I would like to tell you that we are going to use one of the best extensions of PictoBlocks today. So that will require some credits. So I will tell you what exactly the credit is. So let me just get into my account. So what exactly the credit is? Okay, so to use the premium services of the PictoBlocks, you should have the PictoBlocks user credit. so that you can make wonderful projects on artificial intelligence. And you will be happy to know that we have decided to give all the students 5,000 credits very free of cost. The code for the the redemption key would be sent onto your emails, okay, by the end of the day, for so that you can redeem that key and get 5,000 credits. How you are going to redeem that key is, you once you are signed in, you have to click it here. You have to click on the credit, and then you have to click on, give the key which I would be sending out to you, and you have to click on go. Okay, once you will click on go, your PictoBlocks user credits will be increased by 5,000. As I mentioned, we have decided only these for the students who are attending the boot camp. Okay, so this is very important that you check your emails for the code. Okay, we will try to send you by the today. Also, if you are signing in for the first time, you would be getting 1,000 credits for free. So some of you are saying that you already have an account, so it's amazing. In that case, you only need to go to this part, click on credit, and get your keys redeemed, which we will be sharing it to you. Now, coming to the topic of object detector, that how exactly we can make it. So you have 1,000 credits, so it's great, but as I mentioned, you would be requiring more to make wonderful projects, to be part of the Codeover competition. That's why we would be giving you more credits for free of cost. Okay, so now coming back to the activity, right? That is the object detector. So how can we do that? So the most important thing is that we will need to add the extension. So now what do you need to do here is, you will be in need to click on add extension button. Okay, so just give me a second. Yeah, so you will be in need to click on add extension button. Okay, my screen is little blur. Okay, just give me a second. Let me find a solution to it. So just give me a couple of seconds. I'll try to find a solution to it so that you will be able to see everything clearly. Just give me a couple of seconds, students. I think now my screen would be clear, right? So can I have your response, students, that now my screen is clear? I hope now my screen is pretty clear, that now you can see the blocks and everything, right? So now to start with the activity, it's really very important, as I mentioned, that you have to sign into the PictoBlocks. And after signing into the PictoBlocks, now what you have to do is you have to click on add extension. As soon as you click on add extension, so today we are going to use. So I can see some no, yes, okay. So may I confirm this with Nirav? Nirav, is my screen clear? Yeah, hello Nirav, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Your screen is
So
visible. It's clear.
clear. Okay, that's great. That's great. So now the thing which we need to do here as a students, we need to add an extension. So some of you mentioned that you were not able to add an extension. So what do you need to do is you will need to click on add extension button here. Okay, and as soon as you will click it here, you will be able to find the different extensions. So the extension what we used last day was face detection, and today we I can see you guys are mentioning about different extension, or I should say the extension which you are going to use. Okay, how can we download the PictoBlocks in our Android phone? So now you can download it in your Android phone directly by searching it onto the Play Store, or also we would be sharing you the link. Okay, so don't worry about it. We would share you the link so that you can access, you can directly download it. So today we are going to add an extension that is AI extension, right? And here I can see Vedant. Yeah, I would request not to spam the chat. It's good, Vedant, that you know it and we can see it clearly, but don't spam the chat, okay? So yeah, we have added an AI extension. This, of course, requires an internet. Right. So now coming to the part that how we should start. So today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the first block, that is when green flag is clicked. So I hope this is pretty clear to you, means it is visible, although I'll just try to make it more visible. Okay, so the first block is when green flag is clicked. Now, a very important thing is that we need to give the data. Right. So how can we do that is we would be able to doing that by using a block into an AI extension that is turn on the camera. So this is the block. Okay, let me just minimize a little bit. Yeah. So this is a block, students, where you will be able to see the video on your PictoBlocks. So as soon as I click it here, I would be visible onto I would be visible here as well, right? So I think I'm visible onto your PictoBlocks as well, right? So now this is going to help me to detect the objects from the camera. But if in case I want to detect the objects from different images, in that scenario, what you are going to do is you are going to add a backdrop. Okay, and after adding a backdrop, you would be recognizing the things. So the next very important block which you need to use is that is the recognize the image feature from the stage. Okay, and this is the block, students, very important because this is only going to recognize the different things. The first block was going was opening the camera. The second one is detecting the images, detecting, or I should say recognizing, analyzing the images from the stage. So this is very, very important. Now, the things come up that there could be many objects on the screen. Right now, if I talk about, so you can see many objects, right? So, okay, just let me just go through with the chat. Okay. Okay, so now coming back to this activity, as I mentioned, the next part is like we would be detecting many objects, but of course we would also know the counting of the objects, right? That how many objects are exactly present right now. So to count those objects, so someone asked me this question on the first day that what exactly the variable is. So student, variable are like a box where you can store the numbers or you can store the alphabetical units that we called as a string. Okay, so you can store a string or you can store a number inside a variable. And you can make your own variable using an option of make a variable. And why we are making a variable? So that we can keep a track that how many objects are currently present on the screen. So I'm going to click on make a variable and I will give the names as objects. And I would be keeping the data type as number, because of course I want to store the number here, and I'll just click it here. And as soon as you click OK, you would be able to see the objects coming up on the stage. So this is by this checkbox. So if I'm going to uncheck this, it will go away. If I'm going to check this box again, this would come up. A very important thing here, students, is that again, like on every detection, like every time I'm starting a program, I want my machine to start the counting from zero, right? Okay, can you zoom onto the box? Dear, if I zoom it, it will just go a little bit. It will just get cut. Okay, no issues. I think you would be able to see now. Okay. So what we have to write on key while signing is, so you don't need to write anything. That's an optional, Nashita. You can just keep it blank and get into the next step. Okay. So now, students, as I mentioned, I have already clicked in onto the all sprites. Okay. So I was telling you about this was the first step, and we created my variable to get the keep the track of number of objects in my image, or I should say on the live camera. But of course, as I mentioned, every time this program is starting, it is very important that the counting start from zero. So for this, I have a block that is set my variable to zero. And here I would need, you can name it at objects. Yeah, I have named it at object. So now here you have to select the name of the variable, what you have created, right? So you have to select it as zero. And why am I doing this? As I mentioned, that every time I start a program, my machine should start the counting with zero. It should not be like this, that in this image, there were three objects. So it counted one, two, and three. And in the next, it count the counting started from five, four, five, six. To start every time with zero, we are putting up set the objects to zero. Now again, there are some very important concepts. So Arnav, we would be sharing you the link of attendance, or you can even see the attendance link on top of your chat box. Now coming to the part that, of course, the number of times the object is going to be there, we need the number of times the sprites are coming. Okay. So one of the major thing I wanted to tell you here was that today we won't be using the Toby as a sprite. Okay. We would be changing our sprite. So what am I going to do here is I'm going to choose a new sprite. Okay. And that would be a square box. Because to locate the object, of course, I won't be able to do it with the Toby. So if I want to locate the objects, I want some sprite like a square box that can help me to locate the objects. Okay. So this is why I'm choosing the square box as a sprite. But now you would be thinking that I have written everything in Toby. I'm not able to see it on square box. Okay. So no issues. What you can do is you can just give me a couple of seconds. So now if you have, you are seeing this square box as an empty. So what do you need to do is you need to just drag this script and go to square box. And if you will see square box moving, right? You will see the square box is shaking. The sprite is getting shaked. In that way, you would be able to copy the sprite. So this was very important thing I wanted to cover, that how you can, I should say, copy the sprite script from one sprite to another. So now I would be deleting the Toby from here. So now I only have one sprite, that is the square box, which I would be using to locate the different objects. Okay, so I can see students are also sharing the attendance form. So Arnav, I would request you not to spam the chat. We would be sharing you the link of the attendance form. Okay, so I'm keeping the chat off for some time so that everyone in the chat can get the link for this form. Okay, so now as I mentioned, I have added a square box as an sprite, and I copied the complete script from Toby to square box. Now, how many times I want this sprite to locate the objects? Okay, so this should be equal to the number of objects, right? So like right now, if I say there would be 5 objects, so I want my square box to move 5 times. So this is one object, this is one object, this is one object, this is one object, right? So my sprite should move 5 times, or I should say it should come up 5 times onto the screen. And to repeat the things, as I have mentioned, that you need a block which says repeat. So I'll just bring this block which says repeat. So now you can see there is a number. Of course, we are not confirmed with the number, right? Because there can be 5 objects, there can be 10 objects, or there can be 1 object. So what we can do is we can use an option that is recognize object count, okay? And this is going to automatically update that how many times do I want my sprite to come up on the screen. Now the next point, which is very important, as I mentioned, so we need to track. So we need to track the number of objects. So to track, of course, we would be in requirement to increase the number as well. So first time it's 0. So after once one object is counted, we need to add one number, right? So we'll go to variables and we will change the variable by 1. So the name of my variable here is objects. So every time a new object is detected, I want it to get added to 0. Okay, this will start increasing the number so that at the end of the program, I would be able to get the final number of objects. Now, here comes a very important concept that we have only one square box, right? But we can have a multiple objects on the screen. So how can I get my box, or I should say, how can I get my sprite multiplied by many times? Or how can I get multiple sprites with only one sprite selected? So we can get multiple sprites with only one sprite selected by creating the clones of that sprite. And you can do it very easily by choosing the control. And what do we need to do is we have a block which says create the clone. So here you will see there are 2 blocks, and these are a complementary blocks. That means if you are going to use this block, you have to use this block. Okay, because if you are asking the sprite to clone, then in that case, you also need to mention that what should be done when you are creating a clone. So this is why we are creating a clone here. Okay, and now we are also using that when I start as clone. So what do we want to do when we start as clone? The first very important thing would be that I want my sprite to set its size. Okay, so how can I do that? So in the looks, we have a block which is going to help me set the size too. So I'm taking down this, okay, and this is written as set the size too. But what I want, how exactly, what should be the size of the box which is coming up? So it should be something, I should say, big enough to surround the object which it has located. So what do we need to do here is we are going to go to the artificial intelligence, and we are going to go to image features, and here you are going to get an block which is going to say recognized object count, and instead of x you can choose the height. Okay, so right now I'm setting the object, or I should say I'm setting, let me just minimize this here. So I'm setting basically the size of the sprite. Okay, what I'm doing, I'm setting the size of the sprite that it should be equal to the height, or it can be also the width. So we have seen that it's we find a good answers with the height. So this is what we are doing, that if it is coming on my face, so right now you can see it is not covering all of my face. So I want that when it is finding the object, it should be also getting a size of the object. Okay. Now, the second important thing, as I mentioned, that in object detection, it's very necessary that it locates the object. That if it is detecting me, it should come here. If it is detecting robot, it my sprite should go somewhere in the backside. Oh, I'm not able to hold this. Yeah. Okay, now it should come here. It is, if it is detecting some other, so it should locate that object, right? So to locate that object, we have to go to the motions, and we have an option to set the X and Y coordinates. Okay, so I will take two of the blocks, that is set X2 and set Y2. And here we are going to choose the same block, okay, that we used was, so let me just bring it down, that is recognized object X position, recognized object Y position. So I will just change it to Y position. So I will again explain you this part, that when I started as clone, that I mentioned ki when I would my sprite would be making its clone, I want the clone size should be the height of the objects detected. It should be located at the X position of the object detected. It should also be located at the Y position of the object located, right? After this, of course, a very important thing is to get the name, okay? So what do I will do is, I'll just go to looks. Oh, I'm sorry. I'll go to looks and bring up this block which says say. Okay, and this is going to help me to say the name of the object. And again, I will go to artificial intelligence, and I have a block here which is going to help me to say the name, which you can see it here. Okay, now you would be thinking that we are tracking the number, but why we are tracking the number? So we are tracking the number because, so means I should say, we would be able to locate this box onto different objects. We are numbering the objects, right? So here on this part, when I started as clone, you can see all the numbers are 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so what it is going to do is, it is only going to come up over the, I should say, the object number 1. Okay, and it is only going to set its height as object number 1. But of course, we don't want that. What we want here is, it should come up onto all the objects. Like it should come onto the object number 1, then it should come up onto the object number 2, then it should come up on the object number 3, and it should be done automatically. So I'm going to bring this object variable which contains the different, I should say, it contains the different numbers inside it, right? So I'm just going to put object inside this. I'm also going to put object inside this part so that it gets automatically update and the things come up onto all the objects which are detected. Okay, so I'll just minimize this so that you can see the complete script in one go. Just give me a second. Okay, little bit here. Okay, I think now it would be clearly visible. Okay, and now let's see whether it works or not. I will show you one important concept here. Okay, so now what do I need to do is, let's keep this sprite somewhere at the corner. Okay, I want all of you to focus there that I'm keeping this sprite at the corner. Okay, and now if I'll click it on the green flag, so now you can see the two sprites came up. The first was a person. So this is what I wanted, right? So I wanted it should come up with my height. So what exactly the my height, which is visible on the camera. So box came up with that height. Again, on the glasses part, so it came up with that height. Or you can choose the width also. So it's totally upon you. But a very important thing, it detected two objects. And here there are two clones coming up, but as I mentioned that this was the original sprite and it was still there at the corner. So what do I want to do is I will be in need to hide it. So I can go to looks and what I want is I want my original sprite to be hidden. So I'm just directly going to put a hide block here onto the top. This is going to hide the original sprite and it will only bring the clones. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to bring a show here and I'm going to put it show when I start as clone. So I'm hiding the original sprite and only showcasing the clones of it, right? Now if I'm going to click on green flag, now you can see the original sprite is hidden. And now let's see. So now you can see it has came up with person and the glasses. So you can see if I use the width, although it's covering due to width, what it is doing is it is covering my whole face. That is why I thought of keeping it to height. Then also you can see every time I'm starting it, so the objects are getting changed, or I should say the number is getting updated by 2. So now you can see how easily it is getting the things detected. So I can try one more thing here. I have a bottle. So let's see whether it is able to detect this bottle or not. Okay, it was not able to detect the water bottle. Let me just try it again. So now you can see it detected the 3 objects, right? First one was the person, second one was the glass, and the third one is the bottle. So now this way you would be able to detect the different objects. Now coming to a very important part that students might be facing. Okay, so let me just see this. Okay, that you mentioned that how do we use the camera into the PictoBlocks of the smartphone, right? So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to stop my share and reshare the things for you. So I would now share my screen of my phone so that I can show you that how you can do the things in your phone as well. Okay, so this is my PictoBlock software and this is my screen of phone, right? So I think now you would be able to see this part as well. So what do you need to do is I'll just first change a little settings here so that I can be located to some different place. So now I think I'm good. Okay, so now the first thing comes up that how you can sign in, okay, into the PictoBlocks. Okay, so let me just try to, so I'm switching off my camera for as of now so that you can see the screen properly. Okay, so the first important thing to sign in is you need to click on this part. Okay, this is signing in option. You need to click on this and this is saying already signed in. So I can sign out myself from here. Okay, so do you want to sign out? I will say yes. Now what do I want to do is, again, I need to click it on signing in option. And here you can see you will get something like this, where you need to click on register, and the same process has to be followed, whether it's yes, whether it's no. Okay, so you can keep it yes, and then you can give your three details, click on create account, and then you will be signed in. Now the second part comes up is I will just first sign in myself. The second thing, so very important, comes up here is that how we need to go to the this part. So what do we need to do is we need to click on this MySpace, okay, and you will come to this place where you can store your old projects. And here you can see a plus button, okay? So this is going to open up a new project. Okay, so if you had this question, so this is very important that it is going to open up a new project for you. And as soon as you come up here, you will be able to see the new screen here, right? So you might be thinking, how can I do the things here? The first very important thing that how you can access the camera is you have to click on the setting. Okay, you have to go to the video, and here you would be able to see the camera one and camera two. Okay, so you can choose camera one and camera two here. So I would choose camera one here. Okay, and it's loading, and I'll just click on back button. So I think my screen is little freeze, so just give me a couple of seconds. I'll try to refresh the screen. Just give me a couple of seconds. So I'm sharing my screen again. Just give me a minute. So I don't know why exactly this is making an issue, but no issues. We have everything on our slide. So just let till the time it would be coming on the screen, I can show you the things on the presentation as well. Okay, so here you would be able to see that we started with this activity, and here you can see all the details that how you have to do the things. So here what I was talking about, that how you can, just a moment, how you can choose a sprite. So you can choose a sprite with this option on the top of the menu bar. You can upload the backdrops by choosing the different options from the screen, like first going through the first option on the menu bar of choosing a backdrop, then coming to this part where you need to choose an option from the bottom corner, and then at the right hand side corner you would be able to see a upload backdrop. So these complete details are present on the presentation. That's why we want you all to go through with the presentation into the free resources which we have shared to you. Again, I would request all the students to fill the attendance form. It's really very necessary. Okay, now talking about the applications of object detection. So object detection are getting applied on video surveillances, crowd counting, pedestrian detection, self-driving cars. Also, we have shared you the link for the project repository, right? So we want you all to click on the link which has been shared so that you can go around and check the wonderful projects on the Project Hub of STEMpedia. We would be going through with the making your own Alexa, that is a speech recognition technique. Before that, we want all of you to register to the website So also some of you mentioned that you guys were finding some issue to register, that I would be taking in Q&A session right now. So we still, if you are not facing any issue, you can directly go and register to the website. So now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you. Okay, so I think the screen has come up. Let me see if I can open the PictoBlocks here. Okay, so here is the PictoBlocks. So I was trying to explain you this part that you need to go to setting. You need to click on video so that you can access the camera. Okay, so from here you can do it. I'll just again show it to you. So let me just click on the full screen. So on the top, there is an option to click on settings. And once you click on setting, you will see a video option. And from here, you can access the camera. Along with this, there were a few parts which needs to be taken care of, okay, which I have already told you. Like you need to, basically, you will be need to add an sprite and everything. So what you can do is, you can just refer to the slides, okay? So I'll just directly go to the website part. So let me just open the website. So we have codeever.org. Some of you who were facing the issue related to the registration. So now, right now I'm switching on the chat so that you can ask your questions. So we have started our Q&A. So you can ask all your questions. So what do you need to do is you have to come to this website that is codeever.org that we have already shared the link. You have to click on register. After clicking on register, you have to fill this form. Then you have to click on register here and this will take you to the payment page. Okay, so I'll just show you to you how exactly that payment page look like. Some of you were also not able to locate the, so you will be directed after once you click on register, you would be directed to this page. So you can pay this money to be a part of, the competition. You can pay this money or you can skip the payment from here. So once you click on skip the payment, you would be directed to this dashboard. And here you have to click on start learning and how to remove the backdrop. Okay, I will just show you how you can remove the backdrop. So here what you have to do is you have to go through with the sessions and then you have to basically complete the quizzes inside this. Okay, so as I mentioned, we would be sharing you the attendance link, but here also you would be able to see as I mentioned that we will be sharing you the replay video link. And here also you would be able to go through with all the things which we have taught, also the replay video, and also you would be able to go through with the quiz. Now after this, if you have learned enough, you can just go to this part, click on course home. So today you have to do the day two and day three session. So you have to complete till object detection. So competition is already started. The last date of submission on the competition is 31st of December. So I had signed in PictoBlocks, but I have forgot the username. What can I do? If you have forgotten the username, don't need to worry. What you need to do here is you have to click on signing in option. Okay, I'll just sign in myself first. So you have to click on sign in, then you have to click on forget username. Okay, this will help you to retrieve the username. So competition has already been started. As I mentioned, Jayshree, how to add a backdrop on the phone. Okay, so how to add a backdrop on the phone. Let me see if I can connect my phone. Just give me a couple of seconds. Okay, so I'm trying to reshare my screen to show you how you can add a backdrop in the phone. Actually, I was about to show that, but due to some error on the internet, I'm not able to do that, but just give me a couple of seconds. So as I was still the time, let me tell you how you can delete the backdrop. Okay, so you need to, if you have added any backdrop, okay, if you add any backdrop here, like I'll add here one backdrop that is the blue sky, okay. So what you do, you need to do is you have to click on stage, okay, and you will see a backdrop option here. And from here, you can delete the backdrop. Okay, so I hope I have answered your question. How to add a backdrop in app, I'm trying to show you. Sir, can we choose my big brother as my partner? He is in our school. So Radhika, you can have your big brother within your team if and only if you both are, both of you belongs to the same age group. Okay. How to add backdrop in the app. So I'm trying to share, show you that. Just give me a couple of seconds if I would be able to share the screen. Uh-oh. Okay, so now I'm able to share my screen. Just let me go to the PictoBlocks little fast so that I can show you. So hope you would be able to see my screen. Okay, what do you need to do here is you have to click on this first option, okay, which is the backdrop option. And once you click it here, you would be able to see a button, okay, this edit button. As soon as you click on this edit button, you would be coming to the edit option. And here at the bottom, you have to click on add backdrop. And from here, you can add your own backdrop. And also you can upload your backdrop from here. So there are, on the bottom, you can see three things. Okay, the first is paint, second is, I should say, the second is a snapshot. And the third is the upload. So you can upload your backdrop and you can work out your backdrop thing from here. Although this is the complete things are already mentioned on, as I mentioned, these things are already there into the learning material. So don't forget to use that learning material. Okay. So let me take some, can I participate in the competition now? Of course, you can take participation in the competition now by submitting the payment. Okay, so if you have, sir, it's blur. So as I mean, sir, what, just sir, what have to select training partner while registering? So while registering, you have to select STEMpedia as a learning partner. Okay, let me just show it to you. So what do you need to select is you need to select the learning partner as an STEMpedia. So training partner, sorry, you can say. So here is an option of STEMpedia. So you can just select here the STEMpedia. Okay, so I hope I have answered your question. And let me take some more questions here on the chat. Where is the competition link? So competition link is codeover.org. Let me just share it to you so that you can use it. So Nishita, I'm just sharing this to you. Okay, so this is the competition link for everyone. Okay, sir, partner, as I have already answered your question, Tane, that you have to choose STEMpedia. Where is the quiz link? So quiz link is also the same that you have to register to the website and then you can get to the quiz part, okay? So let me see if you have came up with any new questions, but is there any link you can give it, please? Sir, my partner does not want to do competition anymore. I have already registered. So no problem, Manit. You can do it alone as well. You can make the projects. Okay. Okay, so let me see where is the quiz link. So as I mentioned, the quiz link is that you have to register to the website. Okay. Okay, so Harsh, I would request you not to spam the chat. So again, that was all for today, students. As mentioned, that we want all of you to register to the website. Also, as we would be coming up with doubt sessions, so don't worry if still you have a doubt. We would be sharing the things with you to come up on the doubt session where we can clear all your doubts. Okay, how to add backdrop in laptop, please? Okay, sure. So you can add the backdrop in the laptop by you can see here, this is an add backdrop option. You have to click upload backdrop if you want to upload any picture. But if you want to like upload or choose a backdrop from the library, so you can choose it from here. So I think this is pretty clear for all of you. Getting a problem in registration. So Sejal, you can mention that problem into the form which we have shared so that we can reach out to you and we can help you. Okay, sir, except sir, can we submit the exact copy of your project? So Arush, I won't recommend that because of course that is not going to make you win the competition. You can refer to my projects for understanding and learning purpose, but we would highly directly deny you to not to submit the same projects. Okay, so thank you all for being part of the today's session. Don't forget to submit your registrations on the website. Don't forget to fill the attendance form which we have shared it to you. Also, if in case you have any doubts, don't forget to join our doubt session. The links, we would be sharing it to you soon. So I'm just keeping all the links here so that you can take down all the links from here. So this is for the registration, and the link is for filling the form. So thank you again, everyone, for being part of this day 3 bootcamp, AI bootcamp, Mission AI bootcamp number 3. It was amazing to see you all. We would be love to see you back tomorrow learning the new technology, new projects. Till then, bye-bye, take care, stay safe. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.